Boeing has created some crazy features over the years, which includes a few that you might think are a bit weird. From the 777X's exceptional quality to the Dreamliner's latest feature, these are the 9 unique Boeing features that you didn't know. And at number 9, we have to start with the 787's electrically powered brakes. Boeing didn't want hydraulic systems to power the brakes, as it has a considerably higher weight cost, which is more fuel consumption and more carbon emissions. Therefore, they went with electrically powered brakes as they are easy to change when needed and can be closely monitored due to their smart features, which makes them more efficient. Smart move, Boeing. But what's even smarter is this next feature of the 787. As part of the engine operation, the air used in plane cabins is first generated out of the high-pressure compression stage, and then into the air conditioning system. This is how most airplanes generate air. But Boeing wanted to do something different, which is why they decided to generate air from outside. Instead of generating it from the engine, 2 inlets are on 787 Dreamliner aircraft that allow air to go in, and it is fed to 4 electrically powered cabin air compressors. From the compressors, it goes into 2 air conditioning packs where the temperature and humidity is controlled. And after that, it ultimately gets into the cabin, which makes us passengers arrive at the destination less weary. Boeing's decision to allow fresh air in the cabin was one that many don't use. But when the 747 introduced this new feature, every airline wanted one. The Boeing 747 didn't just get its name Queen of the Skies by mere coincidence. It was because it was grand enough to be considered the queen. The regular seating capacity of the 747-8 is about 375 due to all the aircraft's fixtures. But if everything was removed, and there is a need for it, it can hold over 1,000 people. And one of the reasons for it was because of the hump. The hump is where the cockpit is located. But what's unique about it is that it is designed in a way that the nose door can be installed for cargo loading. For commercial aircraft, the nose initially served as bars, lounges, and restaurants. But when the oil crisis in 1973 occurred, many airlines filled the space with seats and thus were able to get value for their money. But along with this 747 feature, Boeing is also known for setting trends. And since environmental awareness has become a huge part in aviation, Boeing took note of this and thus started to make aircraft which are better for the environment by making it quieter and more fuel efficient. But one of the reasons it's fuel efficient is because of this genius feature, which you might not know about. Most aircraft use air from the engine to generate hot air through the wing's leading edge, which prevents ice from forming. But the 787 does it differently. On the edge of the aircraft, there are electrically heated blankets, which generate enough heat to prevent ice from forming on the wings. And thus, this fuel efficiency of the aircraft is partly due to Boeing's anti-ice system. But while Boeing has made these great features over the years, some didn't turn out well, which even created havoc for Boeing. In March 2019, the 737 MAX family was grounded, and it was because of 2 fatal events that occurred due to a faulty fixture in the aircraft. The reason behind it was the angle of attack sensor, which was faulty and passed the wrong information to the Maneuvering Characteristics Augmentation System, MCAS. The AOA sensor detects incoming hazards and sends them to the MCAS to counteract. So when the sensor is faulty, it sends attack signals which triggers a reaction from the MCAS. One thing that affected the 737 MAX 8, which was the model that was involved, was that it had only one sensor, because the designers believed one was enough. So when it developed a fault, it had no other support. But after that incident, the FAA has made it mandatory for aircraft to have 2 sensors, and the MCAS to compare readings and to ensure they are within 5.5 deg before taking any action. Along with following the regulations, the vice president of the 737 MAX, Mike Fleming, has also revealed that the 737 MAX 10 has monitors which would indicate if the AOA is faulty. While the AOA did not go well for the 737 MAX, Boeing's new 777X did come out with an amazing feature, which is simply perfect. The folding wingtips are not something new, as they can be found on naval aircraft as well, but it's being mentioned because it has never been found on commercial airplanes before, until Boeing introduced it on the 777X model. The wings on the 777X model are similar to that of the 787, but because its tips can fold, it makes them entirely different. The reason behind the folding tips is that the 777X is the largest twin-engine jet, which might be weak considering its huge size, and thus can also create a problem at an airport which has a small tarmac. But with the folding wingtips, the jet becomes smaller and easier to maneuver on the runway. And with the help of twin engines, it makes the plane lighter and the flight more efficient. But even though the 777X got some new features, Boeing still kept some parts of it the same as their old aircraft, which might be shocking and even a bit controversial. When you look at several planes, they all have some similar features, as those are necessary for every airplane to have. Thus, before 1985, every commercial aircraft had a central yoke used to maneuver the aircraft, giving pilots manual control over the functions. But then, Airbus decided to do something different, which they ultimately did by introducing the side stick to its A320. This decision came with the new fly-by-wire system, which replaces manual flight controls with computer-based controls, and even made several aircraft manufacturers follow this trend. But not Boeing. Despite upgrading several other features in the airplane, such as the 777X's touchscreen flight deck, to this day of recording, all Boeing aircraft still feature the central yoke system. Although it is mostly similar to its predecessors, it has a fully configurable dual pilot display and heads-up display as well. And one of the reasons Boeing decided to stick with the central yoke was that they wanted pilots who had trained with the central yoke system to handle the new side stick design. But after contemplating a side stick, they discarded the thought because the central yoke was still efficient. But while the 777X has obviously gained a lot of attention because of its wide body and becoming the largest twin-engine airplane ever, the 737 MAX 10 is still not much ignored, as it comes with some features which are way different from its predecessors. To avoid a tail strike, where the tail of an airplane touches the ground during takeoff or landing, this plane's designers decided to make a different landing gear. It extends on rotation and then collapses back for storage into the same sized wheel wells as its predecessors. This extension is due to the addition of a spring-loaded lever, which is why this new feature makes the MAX 10 desirable. And with all these unique features, we can say that Boeing's features are problem solvers. But one problem we'll still pray against when traveling is that it shouldn't hit any turbulence. And as it turns out, the Boeing company knew how inconvenient the turbulence made the passengers. So when they were designing the 787 Dreamliner, they added a unique feature that would detect incoming turbulence and allow the plane to act against it. The designers added sensors to the aircraft, which can detect air velocity and pressure changes. These sensors send the information gotten to central processing computers, and if the information shows that the plane is about to hit turbulence, it sends electrical signals to the actuators on the wings and tail to act against the force the aircraft is about to experience, which is how passengers can have a smooth ride without knowing what happened behind the scenes. But while Boeing seems to have solved many issues with smart solutions, that is not true for all of their problems, as they have been suffering from some innovative and financial troubles as well. Although the 787 is providing huge support to Boeing by performing well in the aviation market, that might not be enough, as the problems seem to have gone out of control for Boeing. But what are all these problems that Boeing is suffering from? And more importantly, can the 787 save the company from any potential disaster? I know you want to hear some more about this, so just click this video right here.